Hi there. Welcome back to our video series on HR-driven provisioning. My name is Chetan Desai, and I'm a product manager on the Azure AD team. In our last video, we reviewed the two main solution components involved in HR-driven provisioning, the Azure AD provisioning service that provides native connectors to HR apps, and the provisioning agent deployed on-premises to manage AD user accounts. In this video, we will walk through the 7-step process to deploy HR-driven provisioning from Workday to your on-premises Active Directory. If you don't have an on-premises Active Directory and want to provision cloud-only users directly to Azure AD, you can still follow along. We will call out steps that you can skip if your target is Azure AD. Let's get started with step one. In this step, we will log in to the Entra admin portal and create the Workday to AD user provisioning app from the Enterprise App Gallery. If you have multiple AD domains to manage, you can create multiple provisioning apps, one for each AD domain. In the Entra admin portal, access the Enterprise Applications blade. Click on New Application and search for Workday. You will see three different applications that support provisioning capability: the Workday Writeback app, the Workday to Azure AD User Provisioning app, and the Workday to Active Directory User Provisioning app. If you want to provision cloud-only users, select the Workday to Azure AD Provisioning app. In this case, since we want to provision on-premises Active Directory, I'm going to select the Workday to Active Directory User Provisioning app. Provide a descriptive name to this app. And click on the Create button. In our next step, we will download and install the AD Connect provisioning agent on a Windows server that has connectivity to the on-premises AD domain services. If you want to provision cloud-only users to Azure AD, you can skip this step and go directly to step three. In the Entra portal, open the application created in step one and go to the provisioning blade. Set the provisioning mode to automatic and click on the banner displaying the provisioning agent installation instructions. Download the provisioning agent and install it on a Windows Server machine. On the Windows Server, run the provisioning agent wizard. Select the option to enable HR-driven provisioning extension. In the next step, we connect to your Azure AD tenant. And after the connection is successful, we select the AD domains that you'd like to manage using this provisioning agent and register the AD domains with your Azure AD tenant. Now that we have established connectivity to the on-premises AD domain, we will now establish connectivity to the Workday tenant and configure the API endpoint. For this, you may have to engage your Workday admin to create an integration system user account with permissions to access the Get Worker web service. For specific configuration steps, refer to akms/workday. Now that we have completed the connectivity prerequisites, go back to the Entra portal, open the application provisioning blade, and enter the following credential details in the admin credentials section: the Workday service account username, password, the web services URL, and the Active Directory domain that you want to manage. The AD domain dropdown shows all domains registered using the provisioning agent wizard. Click on Test Connection to verify the connectivity with Active Directory and also with Workday. In step four, we will configure scoping rules, which is a mechanism to restrict the provisioning app to select a group of users. This is helpful when you are initially testing the integration or if you want to perform a phased production rollout by department, country, or region. A related best practice that we recommend is setting the skip out of scope deletions flag, which you can set using the link shown here. Expand the attribute mapping section and click on provisioning workday workers. The source object scope is by default set to all users. You can edit this to add your own scoping filters. In this case, I have set it to process users belonging to the finance and administration department, and the manager of that department is Teresa Serrano. Under target object actions, you can also specify the actions that you want to limit the app to perform in your Active Directory domain. In this step, we will configure how attributes flow from Workday into your Active Directory domain. The provisioning app ships with a default set of mappings. Based on how you handle pre-hire processing, conversions, and terminations in Workday, you can customize the attribute mappings. Refer to our Workday integration guide for more details on customizations. Okay, now let's look at the attribute mapping section in our provisioning app. The first attribute mapping here shows the matching identifier attribute that will be used to link Workday profiles with AD accounts. By default, this matching identifier is the Workday worker ID that matches with the AD employee ID attribute. In this setup, I have also used expression mappings to generate unique user principal names and to create users in a specific organizational unit within Active Directory. To add new mappings, click on the Add New Mapping link. You are now ready to test the provisioning flow from Workday to AD. We recommend using the Provision on Demand capability to test the flow individually for a few users. Depending on the complexity of your provisioning flow, it is a good practice to first test the integration in a non-production setup before promoting the integration to production. To test using Provision on Demand, open the provisioning blade of your application. Click on Provision on Demand. Enter the worker ID of a worker in Workday that you would like to test, and click on Provision. The provisioning app will pull worker information from Workday, apply the sync rules configured in the attribute mapping, and display the final result. You can review each provisioning step here and check if it works as expected. We now come to the last step in this configuration, to monitor the provisioning flow and trigger alerts on certain operation failures. You can configure Azure Monitor, referring to the link shown here. If you want to trigger additional automations for your joiner, mover, lever scenarios, we highly recommend configuring the Azure AD Lifecycle Workflows feature. To access Azure AD Lifecycle Workflows, open the Identity Governance blade in the Entra portal and click on Lifecycle Workflows. Here, you can use predefined templates to configure joiner and lever workflows. For example, to define a joiner workflow with a pre-hire record, you can use the onboard pre-hire employee template. With that, we come to the end of this video. Thank you for watching. Hope you found this video useful. To learn more and for links to documentation on this topic, check the description below. See you next time.